Good morning, Hope Church. Morning from the Gregory home. What a fantastic opportunity it was to worship with many churches and who knows who else on Good Friday. We're here to worship. Christ is risen. It's a day that we can celebrate that fact. So we're going to start off with Thankful Hearts. It's a song that's come out of Relational Mission. So some of you may know it, some of you may not. But as always, the words are going to be on the screen and it's quite simple to pick up. So here we go.
You are the God who made the mountains. You are the God who named the stars. You are the God who took our burdens. You are the God who bore our scars. You are the God who paints the heavens. You are the God who parts the seas. You are the God who we call Father. You are the God who sets us free. Hallelujah, you are faithful, never failing, King forever. Let the church sing your love, sets us apart. Here I thank for health. You are the God who's fighting for us. You are the God who's on our side. You are the God who heals the hurting. You are the God who loves his bride. You are the God who has the victory.
We're so thankful today. We're so thankful every day, Lord Jesus, for the grace that you pour upon us, Lord Jesus. Lord, we don't deserve it. We haven't earned it, Lord. It is your grace upon us that we can stand here chosen by you, loved by you, loved for eternity. Lord God, I thank you for what this time in the church calendar means, Lord Jesus. And may during this time, Lord, this time of self-isolation, Lord, this time of lockdown, this time of just remembering what Easter Sunday means, Lord Jesus, would we just know and just have just have a fresh revelation of who you are this morning, Lord, we pray. Amen. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. And you would take my pain.
subtitled The Resurrection. Now, after the Sabbath, toward the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, and an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has risen." And he said, "Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. And behold, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. See, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy and ran to tell the disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then he said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." Thank you, Jesus, that you rose again on this day that we remember your resurrection that we call Easter Sunday. Thank you, Jesus, that you conquered death. You rose again from the tomb. When they went to find you, you weren't there. Your body was gone. It was risen. Death had no hold on you. Death now has no hold on us. Thank you, Jesus, for what you have done for us. Thank you, Jesus, for making a way for us to have eternal life with you, to know you in this life, and to know you for eternity in heaven, where we will worship you as we were made to do. Thank you, Jesus, that you tell us not to be afraid. Thank you, God, that this story brings us great joy, that we can go and tell others that you are alive. Thank you, Jesus.
Sing, "Oh, praise the name of the Lord." It's a great narrative of the whole kind of Easter time. I cast my mind to Calvary. And then on the second verse it says, "Then on the third at break of dawn," we get to celebrate.
Oh,
Bless you guys.